Tattoo on your granny's forearm doesn't tell it. Old maps of locomotive tracks cannot convey. And though I picture chimney stacks, I'll never smell it. Or taste the anguish of the ones who got away. Your love had died, but you survived to dream a place that would be safe for all your kind. Then you awoke to find that Zion was a nightmare, and you're a prisoner of time in Palestine. Between the golden beaches and the river Jordan, a desert garden that they call the Holy Land. But if you spoke to Jesus, Moses, or Muhammad, this isn't quite the paradise that they had planned. How did this promised land of flowing milk honey, where three religions knelt before one living God, become a place where flowing blood and foreign money oy o'er the tank tracks where the gentle prophets trod? Before they launched the jihad on the unbelievers, before they the seed of Ishmael to the knife, before the massacre of Sabra and Shatia, before crusaders killed your kids, then raped your wife. The God of love was high above, but here on earth the gods of hate were doing fine. And if you cannot yet forgive them nor forget them, you're still a prisoner of time in Palestine. That family farm that fed us 40 generations apparently was someone else's before that. Now somebody from a European nation says someone else's great-grandchildren want it back. So I must live beyond an artificial border with neighbors who prefer that I did not exist. Stole my olive orchard, then they stole the border, and when I struggle with them, I'm the terrorist. I had a baby, but a settler bullet killed it. I had a job, but now they cordoned off the town. I had a dream, but every time I try to build it, somebody else comes with a tank and knocked it down. A young man's pride, a suicide, a Jewish bride and bridegroom bleeding where they died. And if you say they're not much better than the Nazis, you're still a prisoner of time in Palestine. And if you thought that it was all about the Bible, get with the history of a thousand years or two. It's very nice to know you're in the chosen people, till you discover why it is they've chosen you to be a scapegoat when the rich demand a cut back, the one to blame when people cannot get enough. And when it's not PC to you, you for a punch bag, they'll very kindly let you be their boxing glove. And so the Jews go on to kick the Palestinians, because the rest of us have beaten up the Jews. And for those oil dictators, it's convenient that they've an enemy in Israel to use. So long as Abraham's descendants are divided, so long as grief between them builds a ghetto wall, so long the camouflage and cover are provided for what's the greatest daylight robbery of all? The praying presidents who heat the seat of power, the fossil traders who pollute the corridors, the road of corpses made from Tel Aviv to Basra, keep a stop the pressure on that petrol pump of ours. A fresh excuse for each abuse of terror and of counter-terror in our time. How shall we change the climate globally for freedom while there are prisoners of poverty and crime in Palestine?
Shalom.